Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we are going to look at how you can get AI directly on your phone, whether you use an iPhone or an Android phone. You can have AI assist you anytime you open up the keyboard on your phone. It can write for you, it can rewrite for you. You could even have it summarize those very long email threads. The great news is that all of this is completely free while you're on the go, thanks to Microsoft. Let's check out how you can add this to your phone right now. First, we're going to use AI using Edge, Microsoft's web browser. You can get this through the App Store and also the Play Store. Once you open up Edge, down at the very bottom, you'll see that there's now a Bing logo included, and this is how we are going to interface with the AI. This AI uses ChatGPT4 together with some Microsoft technology called Prometheus, which gives you all of the most recent current events as well. Right here, you can choose a conversation style as you interact with the AI. Here, we could go with more creative. You could also go with balanced, and then there's also the option to be very precise. For this, I just want to stick with the default of balanced. Down at the bottom, you have two different ways to interact with the AI. Here, you could click on the keyboard, and that way you can type with the AI. Or alternatively, and what I find even easier, is simply click on the microphone icon and you can now talk with the AI. So let's test this out. Write a poem about the Kevin Cookie Company. And look at that. Here I now have a poem about the Kevin Cookie Company. Kevin Cookie Company, oh so sweet. Every bite is a delicious treat. That is quality. Down at the very bottom here, I could also see these sources. It looked like it used the kevincookiecompany.com, CNBC, and also youtube.com. Right up on top, I could take a few different actions. Here, I could share the text with others, and I could also copy all of the text. But I could also just copy portions of the text. Here, I simply press and hold on the text, and I could highlight exactly the part that I want. Down at the very bottom, here in the left-hand corner, I could click on this icon and that'll clear out the entire conversation and I can start again from scratch. The one downside of the AI in Edge is it doesn't take the context of the website that you're currently on into account. So you're really just interfacing with AI and it's separate from your browsing activities. Edge isn't the only app with these AI capabilities that Microsoft offers. You can also download the Bing app. This is Microsoft's search app. Or you could also get the Microsoft Start app, which is Microsoft's news app. But when you look at both of these apps, they look almost identical, and that's because they are. In both of these apps, down at the bottom in the center, here too, you'll also see that Bing logo. And when you click on that, that opens up the same AI capabilities that we just looked at in the Edge app. Microsoft is going all out integrating AI into all of their different mobile apps, and Skype, the messaging app that some people still use, is no exception. The way you interact with the AI, though, is just a little bit different. Within Skype, in the bottom left-hand corner, click into the chat view, and then on top in the search field, type in Bing. Right here, you'll see a person named Bing. Let's click on this, and this now allows us to chat with the AI. I'll click on try it. This now drops me into a new conversation with the AI. Down below, I could type in a message and start talking to the AI. I'll click on the microphone to record a message. Write an email asking people what their favorite cookie is. I'll now send this to the AI. And look at that. The AI has now written an email for me asking people what their favorite cookie is. I'll probably have to go in and make a few tweaks, but overall, this looks really solid. Down at the very bottom, if I'd like to now carry on a new conversation with the AI, I simply type in new topic, and that'll reset the conversation. Right up on top, let's click on back. Along with an individual conversation with the AI, I can also include the AI in a group chat. Here I have a group chat where we're talking about cookies. When I click into this, down in the bottom right-hand corner, here we see the Bing logo. When I tap on that, that includes at Bing in the conversation, and I can now ask the AI a question. And anyone else in this group chat can also include at Bing, and they can also interact with the AI. This brings us to the very last Microsoft app that has AI in it, and that's Microsoft's SwiftKey. If you've never heard of this before, SwiftKey allows you to personalize your keyboard. It also helps you write faster, and it even gives you a cloud clipboard. At least that one's just on Android. But by far, the biggest game-changing feature is whenever you open up your keyboard, this gives you access to that Bing logo, which has all of the AI capabilities. Here I am in my inbox, and I have a fairly long email from my manager, Patty Fernandez. It's the Kevin Cookie Company employee newsletter. I don't have time to read all of this, but she usually includes an action in her emails. So let's see if I could use AI to help simplify things. First, I'll press and hold on the email, and right here, let's click on Select All. Then right up on top, I'll click on Copy. Down below, I'll click on Reply, and here, I'll click on Reply. This opens up the standard iOS keyboard, or on Android, the standard Android keyboard. In the bottom left-hand corner, I'll click on this globe icon, and this now activates the SwiftKey keyboard. To switch back to the other keyboard, you could click on the globe again, but if you don't do that, this will now be your default keyboard. And one of the really neat things is, here again, we see that Bing logo. And by clicking on this, this turns on the AI. I'll click on Bing, and here we have a few different options. Here I could simply search for something using Bing. I could also get assistance with tone, or here I could kick off the chat. I'll click on chat. You're probably very familiar now with this Bing AI chat interface. Down below, it says, ask me anything. So let's see if it can summarize this text in 5 sentences. And next, I'll paste in all of that text from that email message. Now that I've pasted in my text, I'll send it to the AI and see what the summary is. And just like that, I get a quick summary of the email message. This is a lot easier to parse. One thing I noticed though is it looks like Patty is asking for volunteers for the night shift. So let me go back to my email and respond to her. Back in my email, let me dictate a message. I can't make it. Now, I don't know if that's a sufficiently good message. I could probably make it maybe sound a little bit more polite. Right here, let's click on the Bing logo. And over here, there's the option for tone. When I click on this, it pulls in my text from the email message. I can't make it. Let's now see if the AI can maybe rephrase it for me. I'll click on the arrow. And look at that, the AI has generated a few different options for me. Here, I have a professional response. Unfortunately, I am unable to make it. Here we have casual. Sorry, I can't make it. Polite. I regret to inform you that I am unable to attend. And then we also have a social post. Can't make it. Sad face. I like the polite response. I think that'll win me some points. I'll click on accept. And that automatically swaps out my sentence for the AI-generated sentence. All right, well, that's how you can use AI on your phone. And who knows, maybe next week, we'll look at how you can use AI through an implant in your brain. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.